In Maths 1, we are studying the last official chapter, which is chapter number 2, quadratic equations. Today, we will mainly focus on one method of solving quadratic equation, which is called the factorization method. These are the two things that we will try to achieve today. One, we will look at some clarifications about quadratic equations that we studied in the last class. Nothing, don't worry, we haven't studied anything wrong, but I think we need some clarification. We need to reiterate certain things for us to very clearly know what is happening. Second, as I said just now, we will start studying about solving quadratic equations, and in that endeavor, we will look at the first of the three methods that we will study in this year, which is factorization method. These are our two objectives for the class. We will need our textbooks, we will need our notebooks. We will need pens and we will need pencils. Pencils we will use on the textbook and pens we will use on the notebooks. So, clarification. Before I clarify something, let me ask you, do you have any doubt with what we studied in the last class about what a quadratic polynomial is, what a quadratic equation is, what is the general form of the quadratic equation, and the questions in practice set 2.1. If you have a doubt, go ahead. Good to know that you don't have any doubt. It was very easy content that we studied. But anyway, I wanted to clarify two things. First, in this question, part 5 of question number 3, question number 3 said, write the following equations in the form ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. That means the equation that was given in the question, we were supposed to convert it to general form of the quadratic equation and then write the values of a, b and c. There is a printing mistake, at least in the textbook that I have and the PDF that I have. It says capital P into 3 plus 6P. The printing mistake is capital P. It cannot be capital P. It is small p. So the correct question here should look like this. P 3 plus 6P equals to minus 5. This is wrong. Next thing that I wanted to clarify and reiterate is couple of questions in question number 2. Actually, two questions, not just one, because part 3 and part 4 of question number 2. Question number 2 of practice set 2.1 says, decide which of the following are quadratic equations. We have to find out which of the equations are quadratic equations. So the way we do it is a little bit different from how we decide about the polynomial. In case of a polynomial, agar humko sirf itna diya hota, x plus 1 by x, sirf itna diya hota, this polynomial is definitely not a quadratic polynomial. The reason is very simple. The power of the first term is y. The power of the second term is minus 1. X to the power minus 1 equals to 1 by x. So that power of x in the second term is minus 1. The moment we get a negative power, forget about this being a quadratic polynomial. This is not even a polynomial. This is not. Be very careful. But when we have an equation with this kind of polynomial, which is this on the screen, then things are different. Now, because it says x plus 1 by x equals to minus 2, we just can't say that the power of x is 1, power of 1 by x is minus 1. Minus 1 is not a valid power for a polynomial, so this is not a polynomial. It will not be right because this is not in the simplest form. We can transform this. If we multiply the whole thing by x, or you can say if we multiply both LHS and the RHS by x. So x plus 1 by x multiplied by x. NH2 is also multiplied by x. Now when on the LHS now, x into x is x square. Now x into 1 by x, this is just like 2 into 1 by 2, which is 1. So now it is 1 equals to minus 2x. And if you write it in the general form, it will be x square. We move the minus 2x from right hand side to left hand side. So this becomes plus 2x plus 1 equals to 0. It is the same equation. They are same. Now that power of first term is 2, power of second term is 1, and the power of the third term is 0. All are whole numbers. So it is a polynomial. The LHS is a polynomial. Not only that, the highest power of this polynomial is 2. So it is a quadratic polynomial. So the entire thing is a quadratic equation. So the difference of approach between polynomial and an equation is, in case of a polynomial, we can just look at the polynomial and figure out whether it is quadratic or not. But if it is an equation, we need to convert it in the general form, and we need to convert it in a way where we don't have any negative powers. Or there may be situations where we may have to convert the equation such that there are no thirds also. Because in case of equation, it is possible to convert without changing the equation. In case of polynomial, we cannot do that. But in case of equation, we can do. Part 3 of the same question, question number 2, reads as y square plus 1 by y equals to 2. So here also, we cannot just say that 1 by y, that power of the term 1 by y is minus 1. So this is not even a polynomial. So this is not a quadratic equation. No, we will not do that. We cannot do that. We should not do that. We should try convert this equation into the general form where all the powers are whole numbers. So just like part 4, here also we will multiply both sides by y. And understand why we are multiplying it with y. We are multiplying because the denominator that we have is y. To remove that, we are multiplying it with y. If the question was like this, then we will not multiply with y. We will multiply with y square, both sides. Now this will become y to the power 4 plus 1 minus 2y square equals to 0. Even then, even now, the highest power is 4, so this is not a quadratic equation. We will take another example. I told you that it is possible that there may be thirds also, you know. So how will that look? The equation which will be given may look like this. Square root of x equals to 4. And forget about quadratic equation. The question can also be about whether this is a linear equation. At the first glance, when you look at the power of x is 1 by 2. Power is not 1. So you will be tempted to say that it is not a linear equation. But look carefully. Can we convert this into a linear equation? Yes, we can. Square both sides. Now we have x equals to 16. This is definitely a linear equation. And both are same. The point I'm making is, when we are trying to find the nature of the equation, we may have to simplify, we may have to do some transformations before we can conclude the nature of the equation, especially the degree of the equation. Always remember this. Next, as we mentioned in the agenda for the day, we will start studying how do we solve quadratic equations. Solve. Remember, we will look at three methods: factorization method, completing the square method, and discriminant method. Today, we will just look at one method, which is factorization method. All of you by now should know what factorization method means because we already studied it in class 9. So, to remind ourselves, what are multiples and factors? If I write 2 into 3 equals to 6, then 2 and 3 are multiples. Is it correct? 2 and 3 are multiples? Absolutely wrong. 2 and 3 are factors of 6. Whereas 6 is a multiple of 2. 6 is a multiple of 3. This is the basic terminology. When we multiply two things and get the third thing, the product, then the product is the multiple of the two things that we are multiplying. And the two things that we are multiplying, they are called the factors of the product. And it just so happens that when we divide the product by one of the factors, the answer is the other factor. It also happens that when we divide the multiple with one of the factors, the remainder is zero. This is the basic meaning of multiples and factors. Let us see if you do it on your own. If I tell you that 3 into 4 equals to 12. 3 into 4 equals to 12. And I will tell you that 3 and 4 are factors of 12. It's very clear, just like the previous example. The question is, can you find more factors of 12? If you can you write it in this form? Something multiplied by something else equals to 12. Can you write it in that form and tell me more factors of 12? Write it in your notebook and then share it with me. So as you have rightly pointed out, another way we can write the same thing is 2 into 6 equals to 12. Another way we can write the same thing is 1 into 12 equals to 1 into 12 equals to 12. So if we list down all the factors of 12, all the factors in the ascending order, then all the factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. Where am I getting this from? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. The factors. It doesn't mean that we can just multiply 2 and 3 and we will get 12. No, doesn't mean that. We will have to take 2 2s and 1 3 and then we will get 12. But what it means is when we divide 12 by 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 6 or 12, the remainder will be 0. This is the meaning of factors and multiples. let us move to algebra now. We are studying maths one, it's algebra. If I write 3x, and if I ask you to convert this into multiplication form, write 3x as multiplication of two things, what will you write? Some of you have got it correct. We can write it as 3 into x. We can also write it as x into 3, doesn't matter. Yaad karo, when we were writing 3 into 4, did we write 4 into 3? Did not. Not required. So 3x can be written as 3 into x. If you want to write it in the same order, mane LHS and RHS, we can say 3 into x equals to 3x. Now tell me, which is the multiple? Clearly, 3x is the multiple. That's the easy question. You are smart. You can answer the more difficult question. What are the factors of 3x? There are two clear factors written on the screen. Identify them. Very good. 3 and x. Because when we multiply 3 and x, we get 3x. We will never write it as x3. That will be wrong way of writing. That's not the standard. Right? So 3 and x are factors of 3x. Let's try another thing. (5y)² (z). What are the factors of this? Try in your notebook and then share with me. So very easy for us to write. That this is 5(y)² (z). This all of us should be able to write. So this gives us three factors, 5, y² and z. But this is not complete. Because 5 can be written as same 5. y² can be written as y into y. So the factors of 5y² z also include y. So the factors are 5, y, z, and y². Very important for us to understand this. We will need some formulae. We will need some formulae for this chapter, for this part of the chapter. Formula for (a + b)² (a - b)² (a + b)(a - b) and (x + a)(x + b). In the next 5 minutes or even less than that, write these formulae in your notebook, take a picture of your page and send it to me on WhatsApp. Waiting for your responses. So as I said, we really have lost the time to understand how these formulae come about, but we need to know what the formulae are. So once again, I'm reminding you that the formulae are (a² + 2ab + b² then (a² - 2ab + b² (a² - b² and finally it is (x² + a + b)(x) + AP. These are all the formulae. These are some of the formulae that we have studied earlier in previous classes. And these formulae, there are other formulae also, other algebraic formulae. We have A plus B plus C whole square. We have A plus B whole cube, A minus B whole cube. We don't need those things for this chapter, but we will need these four formulae. We need to know this formulae, especially the last formula, which is x plus a into x plus b, which is x square plus a plus b into x plus ab, and others also, but mainly the last one. Because now we will be given with this thing on the right hand side. Ye diya rahega hamare paas. We have to find the factors. So we have to convert the equation, convert the polynomial like this. So if we understand the formula, if we understand how these things are being multiplied to find the multiples, then only we will be able to use the factorization property. That is why I told you what I told you. These four things are necessary. Most important is the last one. X plus A into X plus B equals to X square plus X plus A plus B into X plus A into B. So what do we mean by moving from right to left? We have to find the factors. Let us see with examples. First example, pay attention, pay good attention, pay careful attention. Simplest, very simple situation. 2n square minus 5n. How do we factorize it? Factorize it means we need to write this polynomial in multiplication form. We have to write it as product of certain things. When we have such a thing, we try to think which formula can we use. We cannot use any of those formula because it is easier than this. But what we see is in these two terms, first term is 2m square, second term is minus 5m. M is common. So we will say it is m is common. If we take m out of 2m square, that is 2m square में से हमने m बाहर निकाल दिया तो m से m को किससे multiply करेंगे 2m into m by m that means we are left with 2m so if we multiply m and 2m we will get 2m square similarly if we multiply m with 5 we will get minus 5 so now we have written the polynomial in the form of factors. Now the factors are m and 2m minus 5. This is what we need to achieve for the factorization method. For the factorization method to work, factorization method to find the solution. Solution means what should be the value of m. And this we will be able to understand only if we know that when we multiply these two, we get 2m square minus 5m. Yahi to hai. If we don't know this, we will not be able to do this. We will always be confused and we will not even realize when we do something wrong. Hands or thumb. Next example looks like a formula situation. One of the formula was a square minus b square. And we used to get this. We used to get this from a plus b into a minus b. Why am I saying that it is in the same form? Because this is a square and this is 5 square. If I know this, then using this formula, I can write it will be a plus 5 multiplied by a minus 5. So now the factors of the polynomial a square minus 25 are a plus 5 and a minus 5. So for this, I need to know this. Third example, most important example. Now the polynomial is x square minus 4x minus 5. X square minus 4x minus 5. Now, if I tell you that it is in the form x plus a, x plus b, then you will, maybe you will agree, maybe you will not agree. But remember what this looked. It looked like this, x square plus a plus b, x plus ab. So this a plus b is minus 4. This ab is 5. So we have to find a and b such that when we add them, the sum is minus 4. And a plus b is minus 4. And when we multiply them, that is ab, we get minus 5. Now, if you are good with numbers, if you are good with integers, we will be very easily able to do. We can start from the product. If you want, we can start from the sum also, whichever is easier for us. This case, product is easy. Why? Because product is a prime number, 5. So we know the factors of 5 are 1 and 5 only. So the only way we can get 5 is by multiplying two numbers is 1 and 5. 1 and 5. But we need minus 5. That means one of them should be negative. Now, if I take minus 1, then minus 1 plus 5 will be 4. But I need minus 4. So this is not the case. What happens if I take minus 5? When I add 1 and minus 5, I get minus 4. So now I have a and b such that a into b is minus 5 and a plus b is minus 4. So I can write x square. I'm splitting the minus 4x into two parts, 1 and minus 5. So plus 1x minus 5x minus 1. Dekh lo barabar hai. Minus 4x, ko maine likha, minus plus 1x minus 4x. Ideally, I should not have written 1x, I should only have written x because 1 is understood, implied. From here, we can say in these two terms, x square and 1x, x is common. If we take x as common, we are left with x plus 1. In the other two terms, minus 5 is common. We are left with x plus 1. Now the two terms are this and this. Now what is common? X plus 1. Then what is left? X minus 5. Dekho, isi form mein aa gaya. But will we write it directly? Kya hum yahan se yahan seedha likhenge? No, not. It's not advised. We are doing it. It's the same thing, but we will not write it. You will understand why we are not writing, why we will not write it. It's a simple question where the coefficient of x square is 1. So we will think that it will be okay if we write it directly. It will not be the case all the time. So now the factors are x plus 1 and x minus 5. Once we have remembered, once we have revised what factorization means, how we can factorize a polynomial, a quadratic polynomial. Now let us see how we can solve, how we can find the value. So suppose the question is x square minus 4x minus 5 equals to 0. This is an equation. Now it is no longer a polynomial. This is an equation. This is a quadratic equation. This equation is in the general form. Now, when we say that find the solution, it will also mean find the roots. It means we have to find the value of x for which the equation is correct. जब हम लिखते थे x plus 3 equals to 7 and we said let's find the solution. We did this x equals to 7 minus 3 equals to 4. And why is this a solution? Because if we put x equals to 4, 4 plus 3 is 7, which is equal to RHS. Similarly, now we have to find out values for x for which x square minus 4x minus 5 equals to 0 will be equal to 0. That is the task. That is what the question is. Just now we saw that the polynomial x square minus 4x minus 5 can be written as x minus 5 multiplied by x plus 1. So if I write it in a better way, I will clear the screen and write again. Question will be given as this, x square minus 4x minus 5 equals to 6. You will write or x minus 5, x plus 1 equals to 0. कैसे पहुंचे यहां पर? वो step मैंने यहां पर नहीं लिखे. वो step कहां से आएगा? ये होगा. Or x square minus 5x plus x minus 5 equals to 0. Or x minus 5. Plus 1, x minus 5 equals to 0. Or x minus 5, x plus 1. See that the factors are same, x minus 5 and x plus 1. Only their order has changed because I have written the split in the different order. That doesn't change the answer. The answer remains same. Now, what we are saying is, we are multiplying x minus 5 and x plus 1 and we are getting 0. We are multiplying two numbers and we are getting 0. It is only possible when either of them, at least one of them is 0. Basic arithmetic. कोई दो नंबर को अगर हम मल्टीप्लाई करते हैं और हमको आंसर 0 मिलता है, आंसर तभी 0 मिलेगा जब उनमें से कोई एक या दोनों के दोनों 0 होंगे. 5 into 5 is 25, 5 into 4 is 20, 2 into 3 is 6, 2 into 0 is 0, 0 into 5 is 0, 0 into 0 is 0. So when we factorize an equation, quadratic equation in general form, we get an equation where the RHS is 0. That means the product of the factors is 0. That means, ya to x minus 5 is equal to 0 or x plus 1 equals to 0. Now you see the quadratic equation has become two linear equations. Now if x minus 5 equals to 0, we know x will be 5. 0 plus 5 is 5. Similarly, if x plus 1 equals to 0, x equals to 0 minus 1, minus 1. These are the solutions, these are the roots. Just now, we found that x equals to 5, x equals to minus 1. This is what we have found. Let us see if it is right or wrong. So our equation is x square minus 4x minus 5 equals to 0. Try with x equals to 5. If we take x equals to 5, our LHS equals to 5 square minus 4 into 5 minus 5, which is equal to 25 minus 20 minus 5, which is 25 minus 25 equals to 0 equals to RHS. That means yes, it is a root. Last exercise में हमने solve किया ना, how do we check if the given value is a root or not? We put it in the equation and see if the equation is right or wrong. You tell me, what do we do for x equals to 1, x equals to minus 1? What will be the LHS? Speak up. Nope. No one is speaking. So minus 1 whole square minus 4 into minus 1 minus 5. Help me solve this. Minus 1 whole square is how much?
1.
Very good. Minus 1 into minus 4 is how much?
Minus 5.
Minus 1, minus 4 into minus 1 is how much?
4.
Minus 4.
Thank you, Rajesh. It is 4 and then it is minus 5. Minus 1 into minus 1 is not minus 5. Minus 4 into minus 1 is not minus 4. Minus 4 into minus 1 is plus 4. 5 minus 5 equals to 0 equals to RHS. That means x equals to minus 1 is also a root. In linear equation, in one variable, we get one answer, one solution. Quadratic equations in one variable, we will get two answers. Degree is 2, two answers. Linear equation, degree is 1, one answer. Always remember this. This, m square minus 14m plus 13 equals to 0. So it's very straightforward. It's a quadratic equation and the quadratic equation is already in the general form. And whenever we look like, we come across an equation like this, we will try use this formula. Huh? We will try to make it into this form. So we have to find a plus b and we have to find a minus b, not a minus b, a into b. Now look at the equation now and tell me there are three terms, m square, minus 14m and plus 13 in the LHS. Tell me in our x plus a, x plus b form from this equation, we don't have x, we have m, I know that. What will be a plus b? What a and what will be the sum of the A and B that we need to know? No, Prachi, wrong answer. It's not what you said. Keep trying. Karthik, correct. Anyone else? The sum will be the middle number, so minus 14. The coefficient of the middle term is minus 14, not 14. What will be a into b? A into b is 13, very good. Okay. So we have minus 14 here and we have 13 here. So we need to find two numbers multiplying which we get 13 as the product and minus 14 as the sum. 13 is another prime number, na? So it's easy if I start from there. So two numbers when multiplied, we get 13. Only possibilities are 1 and 13. There is nothing else that is possible. But we need minus 14 when we add them. Kya karenge? What will be a and b? It will be minus 1 and minus 13. अगर 1 और 13 होता उसको ऐड करते तो 14 आता. If it was minus 1 and 13, then it would have been plus 12. If it was minus 13 and plus 1, it would have been minus 12. But we need minus 14, so both have to be minus. Then this becomes m square minus m minus 13m plus 13 equals to 0. Or m square and m. मैंने 1 यहाँ पे नहीं लिखा बेटा. Last time मैंने आपको बोला वो वन मैंने नहीं लिखा, बिटवीन एम स्क्वायर एंड एम, एम इज कॉमन, एम माइनस वन. देखो मल्टीप्लाई करने से वही होता है एम स्क्वायर माइनस एम. नाउ बिटवीन थर्टीन माइनस थर्टीन एम एंड प्लस थर्टीन, वॉट आई वॉन्ट इज इन द ब्रैकेट्स आई वॉन्ट एम माइनस वन. So I will take minus 13 as common and we will have m minus 1 equals to 0. Or now the common factor is m minus 1. What remains is m minus 13 equals to 0. Now there are two possibilities, m minus 1 equals to 0 or m minus 13 equals to 0. If m minus 1 equals to 0, m equals to 1. If m minus 13 equals to 0, m equals to 13. So the roots are 1 and 13. So the solution, there are two possible solutions, 1 and 13. Next one. Again, this is not new. We have solved this type of question in class 9. See what the difference is. Now, the coefficient of x square is not 1, but it is 3. Not 1, but it is 3. So we can still convert this in the x plus a and x plus b format. Yes, we can. But there will be a slight change. The change will not be in terms of a plus b. Even in this case, a plus b can be found out in the same way. Tell me how much a plus b will be in this case. Look at the equation carefully. No change in the logic for a plus b. Very good. It is minus 1. The coefficient of the middle term is minus 1. Very good. The change will be in the product ab. In the previous two examples, our product was just the last term. But now it will be the last term multiplied by the coefficient of first term. So minus 10 into 3, which is minus 30. So using this much mental mathematics, or if you are doing written mathematics, finding that 30 can be written as 1 into 30, 5 into 6, any which way we do, we can find out that our a and b will be 5 and minus 6. Will be 5 and minus 6. So I will write, or 3x square minus 6x plus 5x minus 10 equals to 0. You will ask a very important question to me now. Sir, why have you written minus 6x before plus 5x? You could have written it the other way around also. You will get the answer. But the reason I did this is, I know after this I have to find commonality. I know there is between 3 and 6, 3 and 3 is common. Between 5 and 10, 5 is common. It's easy. That is why I wrote like this. Now you help me complete this one step at a time. Between 3x square and minus 6x, 3 is common. 1x is also common. Then if we remove them, if we take them outside, what do we have inside? What are we left with inside?
X minus 2.
We have x and minus 2. Thank you, Rajesh. Then, very clearly, 5 is common. X minus. Very good. Remember, many, 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 most students, they forget this plus sign. And everything becomes wrong. This plus sign is this plus sign. Huh? We are trying to get common here. That is why we have taken plus. अगर हम यहाँ पे माइनस फाइव लेते तो अंदर में आ जाता माइनस सिक्स प्लस टू, उसका हम कुछ कर नहीं पाते. वी नीड एक्स माइनस टू, सो वी आर टेकिंग प्लस फाइव. देन एक्स माइनस टू इज कॉमन, देन वी हैव थ्री एक्स प्लस फाइव. equals to 0. Two possibilities, x minus 2 equals to 0. If x minus 2 equals to 0, tell me how much is x?
2.
Very good. Now if 3x plus 5 equals to 0, then we can say 3x equals to minus 5. Therefore, x will be how much? Minus 5 by 3. Two different values. X equals to 2 and x equals to minus 5 by 3. So we need this, we need this, we need this, we need so much of algebra to find the solutions of this kind of equation. Sometimes the questions can be easy. They may look difficult, but they actually are easy. Now, this question on your screen now, 3y square equals to 15y, does not look anything like it is in the general form. But I'm saying that this is easier. Let us first try convert this in the general form. So, in general form, on the right hand side, we have nothing but 0. Everything is on the left hand side. So, let's take 15y to the left hand side. So, 3y square minus 15y equals to 0. It is easier because there are only two terms. Between 3y square and minus 15y, 3 is common. 3 divided by 3 is 1. 15 divided by 3 is 5. So 3 is common. Also, y is common. If we take this common, then we are left with y minus 5. Now there are 3 factors. Be careful. Now there are not 2, but 3 factors, 3, y and y minus 5. And we say that when we are multiplying these 3 things, we are getting 0. 3 is not 0, we know it. So the only possibility is that either y is 0 or y minus 5 is 0. If y equals to 0, this is one solution. If y minus 5 equals to 0, then y equals to 0 plus 5, that is y equals to 5. These are the two solutions. Once again, it's a quadratic equation and we have two solutions. Another type of question. Once again, it looks difficult. It looks difficult. It does not look in the equation is not in the general form, but we can solve it easily. Yes, sir. Let us try write it in the general form. So we will say x square minus 3 equals to 0. अब तुम डर गए कि minus 3 equals to 0 कैसे करेंगे? अच्छा, ये सोचो. अगर दिया रहता x square equals to 25, हम क्या करते? X square minus 25 equals to 0. फिर हम लिखते, this is x का square minus 5 का square. है ना? Now this is a square minus b square. A square minus b square is a plus b, a minus b. That means x plus 5 equals to 0 or x minus 5 equals to 0. That means x equals to minus 5 or x equals to plus 5. Aisa karte na? ऐसा तो हमने एक और पहले देख लिया x equals to 25 exact यही वाला था a square minus 25 था उसका factorization हमने किया था ना a plus 5 and a minus 5 now the difference here is we don't have 25 we have a 3 which is not a perfect square but we are smart we have studied thirds last year so what we can say is x square, very sorry. Okay, let's try blue. X square minus 3 equals to 0. Or we can say it is x square minus root 3 ka square equals to 0. 3 is square of root 3, Now it is again in the form x square, a square minus b square. So we can say x plus root 3 multiplied by x minus root 3 equals to 0. So x plus root 3 equals to 0 or x minus root 3 equals to 0. If x plus root 3 equals to 0, x equals to minus root 3. If x minus root 3 equals to 0, x equals to root 3. We have two solutions, quadratic equations. This is example number 5 on page number 36. This is another quadratic equation where, and it is, again, it is not in the general form. It says 6 root 3 x square plus 7 x equals to root 3. Once again, no need to worry. क्या हो गया, इसको कैसे करेंगे? बिल्कुल डरना नहीं. What this means is 6 root 3 x square plus 7 x minus root 3 equals to 0. Now we have it in the general form. So when we look at the general form, this is a, this is b, and this is c. Enough in the general form. But for factorization, we need other a and b. A plus b something and a into b something. Look at the equation and tell me what should be a plus b for this equation. What should be a plus b? How much it should be? Very good, Chan. The coefficient of the middle term, 7. Now a tricky question. How much should be a into b? Remember, a into b should be the product of the coefficient of x square and the last coefficient. Multiply it correctly and tell me how much AB should be. Correct, Chan. So 6 root 3 into root 3 means 6 into 3 means 18. We need 18. So we need two numbers such that their product is 18 and their sum is 7. Sum is 7. Now, जैसे ही 18 तुम देखोगे, तुम्हारे दिमाग में आना चाहिए 1 into 18, 2 into 9, 3 into 6. यही आता है ना? 1 into 18, 2 into 9, 3 into 6. Now, one of this combination will give us 7. होना चाहिए. What is that combination? We have to find. But we have already done something wrong. It cannot be 18. It has to be minus 18. Okay. So product should be minus 18 and sum is 7. So this is the combination. Bas, uske aage hum usko split karenge aur usko solve karenge. That is what is given in the textbook. Read. Ask if you have any doubt. That with this study, you will be able to complete practice set 2.2 and submit. If you have any doubt, any single question that you are not able to solve, whether it is from the example or it is from the practice set, we will see it in the next class.